Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. It's late Friday evening, I don't know, almost 11 maybe. Doing the laundry, so thought I'd take a minute and just talk to you. Because, you know, we're all out here trying to wake each other up. And I think a lot of times we forget that there's children involved in our daily pursuit of truth, justice, etc. And you gotta talk to them. You gotta make them aware of what it is you do, why you do it. You gotta keep them informed about what's really going on, and you also have to kind of talk with them. You know, people are going to try to get to you through them, maybe. You know, law enforcement, other entities. When you bring awareness, if they know that you're on your toes and they have nothing on you, then they may try to mess with your teenage kids or whatever the case. You got to talk to your kids. And for any of you people that just say, well, you can't talk to children about this stuff, no, you have to. Now, I'm not saying just hammer them with horrifying facts until they shit themselves. Okay, no, come on. These are your kids. But you can speak to them on a level to let them understand, and they're not going to be scared. Because, see, there's this natural thing between a parent and a child that the parent automatically knows that he has to provide, teach, and defend that child. And that child should naturally know that no matter what, the parent has it handled. They don't have to worry about it. Now, my kids, they're always hearing me talk. And so they're really informed, and I talk to them, and they're not worried. If they have a question, they'll ask. But they spend their days doing things that boys their age do. They play, they laugh, they text, they call their friends, they hang out. All these things. It hasn't hindered their life at all. Funny story, my middle son, Joseph, he's really aware of everything around him. It's awesome. And he said to me that one of his teachers had a mask in her car. And I said, that's awesome, but you need to ask her if it's represents the movie or the movement. And he said to me, what do you mean the movie? So he is totally informed about the movement, but, you know, didn't know about the movie. So he asked her, and evidently, it's in support of the movement, whatever that means to her, I don't know for sure, but he did give her my business card to the website, my contact info, so that's awesome, that's good stuff, you know, but you got to talk to your kids, and you got to think about this, you know, your kids are around, they overhear you, and if you haven't talked to them, they know you're withholding information, then, because you haven't explained to them whatever it is they've overheard, then they begin to worry. Then they begin to worry. And they're going to hear you. You know, we're talking about it. We're doing videos about it. We're tweeting about it. We're Facebooking about it. We're talking about it, hopefully, to our neighbors on the phone. And they're going to hear it. And they're going to pick it up. And if you don't inform them, then they are going to worry. You've got to talk to your kids. And especially now, folks, my feeling is you really have to talk to them about their rights, interaction with the police. I had a talk with my boys earlier because of the recent footage of the state police and local police, you know, breaking the law and me documenting that. Now, I'm not busting anybody's balls. I don't hate those cops for that. They're just human beings, and we're going to do these things. But I just want everybody to play on the same level with the same rules. And I also, you know, there's two sides to this, folks. We got to be on guard against some of the police overstepping the bounds, but also we have to watch that propaganda that divides us from the police, because whether you like it or not, whether you see it or not, this country is in turmoil, and it's going to lead into civil unrest, in my opinion, and you're going to need those police on your side. They're just human beings. But you got to, and I, you know, 50-50, it's a crapshoot, because they're a human being. Keep them on their toes, keep them in check, be very clear. But so anyway, if you're doing that, And you are in an area where there is one of those officers that has an authority trip, they may go through your kids, harassing them. You need to let your children know that they don't have a right to search them. You know, if they have reason to think they need to search them, then they need to go get a warrant. You need to have your number on speed dial. So if the police are harassing the kids, they can just speed dial and call you immediately. And Zach, he's on the ball. He's like, Dad, I could do that because I usually leave my phone on speakerphone so you could hear us. I wouldn't have to say anything. My kids are thinking. But I also had the talk with them at the same time that they need to respect the officers. And if there's a bunch of teenagers hanging out being loud, they're going to come up and they're going to ask a few questions. And it's a fine line, you know. Be polite, be respectful. But if the questions start getting intimidating and you think the officer's going beyond their right, you know, say, am I being charged? Am I free to go? You know? But be respectful. We don't want our children divided from the police, but we don't want them being attacked because of our mission in life to rectify the bullshit that we see either. Okay? So, got to throw it out there because, you know, sometimes we forget about these things, folks. We get so wrapped up in trying to save the world, or at least a few that will listen, we forget about how to handle our kids in this situation. And you can't withhold the information because if you do, that's lying to them. And it has repercussions that most people can't even understand. But, you know, it does. It'll cause a division between you and your kids. You must tell them the truth. You must do it on a level that they'll understand. And I don't know how old your children are, so that'll be different for each one of you. The best thing is to know your child. Know how much they can handle. Talk to them in their language. You got your little language with them, however you talk to them. Talk to them. Talk to them about Fukushima. Talk to them about the law. Talk to them about their rights. Now, this just came up today, and this is a miracle. I want to share this with you guys. Because I think you know that I don't follow what the public school tells me I have to do. In this situation with my middle son, Joseph, who does have a learning disability and is hyperactive, the new staff that handle him are outstanding. I can't say enough about the lead of that, Sarah Durst. She's somebody I knew from high school, and she's really working hard. But because of protocol, and because of some of this behavior stuff with Joseph a while back, she wanted me to get a note from the doctor giving him the label of ADHD in a protection for him so that if he had some issue, there's less likely to be criminal interaction. So she was looking out for him, but I think, anyway, we booked the appointment, and because I'm not big on giving kids labels, but I saw the reality, the way she presented it, and booked the appointment. And then got hectic last week and missed the appointment. And was getting ready Monday, this coming Monday, to make the appointment, you know, reschedule. And I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to do that at all. And this is why. We already see the gun control thing, and we see New York taking guns away from people with mental health issues. Now, I don't know. But I'm not going to risk his right to own guns on getting a label on him now. And I discussed this with him earlier today as well. And he agrees. He said, there's nobody that's going to take my gun rights, Dad. And not that we're big gun hounds. We you know, the kids have air rifles. You know, they will hunt. They have shot rifles. But we're not big gun heads. But we are big on our right to, if we decide to. And so I'm not going to do that. And thank God that we missed that appointment, you know, because it gave me time to review a few more headlines and that click that, hey, they're doing it in New York. ADHD is could be seen as a mental health disorder. And they could justify that to the sheep. Come on. This kid's hyperactive. He had behavioral issues at school. He cannot be safe with a weapon. Bullshit. Bullshit. My children are actually probably have more self-control when they have the gun in their hand because they know it's playtime is over. Okay? They're serious business. Anyway, I wanted to throw that out there to you, in case any of you are in that situation. You'll think about that. I'm leaning towards just my life. I don't really give a fuck what you write down on paper and call law. If I can see that law infringes on my rights, there's a good chance that I'm going to ignore it. Okay? Because you don't have the right, and it's got to stop somewhere. And I've had enough. And I hope the rest of you have had enough. Anyway, before I start to rant and swear and all those other things that I'm trying not to do, I'm going to go for now. But anyway, much love, many thanks, and I'll either see you or talk to you soon.